tell you that I did it for my wife, so that she and I might grow old and gray together. I wish I could tell you that I did it for my kids, so that they may have their dad well into their adulthood, and so that one day maybe their kids would know their grandfather. And while that might be the net result, it was not my original motivating factor for getting a bit fit. Madam Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters and guests, there I sat in a hump. I was completely winded. My back was on fire. My knee had just given out again. It literally had its own heartbeat. I was embarrassed. I stared up at my opponents and I could think of only one thing to say. I was fouled. Dad, nobody touched you, my 10-year-old son said. You just fell down. My wife and daughter, they turned and shook their heads in shame. It was at that moment I realized I was the most unfit person in my family. But I was determined to do something about it. So I picked myself up, well, my wife and my son gotta help me up. And they got me into my easy chair inside where I was able to start my Google search. How to beat your kids in basketball. I think I Googled something like, get fit. To which Google replied, do you mean Fitbit? I said, I don't know, Google, maybe I do. So after reading all of the reviews and hearing about how this Fitbit has changed people's lives, I decided that I had to have one. I had to have one right then and there. Alexa, order me a Fitbit. Okay, John, would you like me to deliver it prime for today? Absolutely, yes, please. At that moment, my wife came in and said, you can't even walk right now. I said, I don't care, I'm determined. A few hours later, I got my new toy. I teared open the packaging, I downloaded the app, and I was ready to go. The ancient Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu said that the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Mine was gonna be more of a limp, but I was ready to go. Over the next few weeks, how I was going to become the most fit person in my family started to take shape. When you first get the Fitbit, it starts with 10,000 steps as the default goal, which is the recommended daily step count by the American Heart Association. I found that that came pretty easy. So I started to play games with myself, like how early in the day could I get to 10,000? How many days in a row could I do 10,000? How many over 10,000 could I do? And then one beautiful spring morning, I decided to go golfing at about 6 o'clock in the morning. And at this ungodly hour, I typically rent a cart, but I needed the steps. So I carried my clubs, and for 18 holes, I lugged them around. And as I got to my car, I looked at my watch, and I saw it was 10:30. And then the magic number burned into my psyche, 20,000 on the number. I had my new goal. I was very flexible with myself to come to this goal, but I was passionate about it. I said, if I can get to 20,000 steps before 11 o'clock, I can do it every day. Now, I didn't mean for it to become a streak, but that's what happened. One day turned into two, 1 week turned into two, 1 month turned into two, three, four. 213 days, actually. On day 214, I went out with some colleagues, and came home, and I crashed on the couch. I woke up a little bit after midnight, and I was sweating. I saw zero steps. I reached for my phone. I looked at the app, 16,500. I had failed. I was ruined. It was over. I took my Fitbit out, I threw it in the kitchen garbage, and I went up to bed and cried myself to sleep. The next morning, my wife was standing over me with my Fitbit and what appeared to be some yolk that was about to drip on my face. I was literally about to have egg on my face, so I fessed up. I said, I failed. It's over. She said, no, it was never about the street. And she reminded me that it was about the lifestyle change. And she reminded me of all the things that I was bragging about over the last few months, the weight loss, my heartbeat coming down, the more energy that I had to play with my children after work. And she was right. I was then reminded of a book that I was reading where John Acuff talks about the day after perfect, separating starters from finishers. That day after you have the really bad meal, do you skip the whole diet? The day after you miss the gym, do you stop going? The day after 20,000 steps is over, do you stop trying for that to be your goal? So I realized she was right, so I got up and I started going. I had all these fringe benefits that I never even realized by having a goal. Things like not sweating the small stuff. I used to go into the parking lot and drive and try to find the closest spot. I would circle over and over. Now I park as far away as I can. I need the steps after all. And I see those crazy people going over and over. So I win the time game too. I get in there. And time management is critical. 20,000 steps, they don't step themselves. So I have to plan out when I'm gonna go for a run, when I'm gonna go for a walk, fit that into my business world. And being a salesperson, time management is critical. So it's actually helping professionally too. And it may seem trivial, but my math skills are through the roof. I'm seeing numbers like I did back when I was in school. I'm constantly dividing and multiplying and subtracting, adding. How many more steps is it gonna take? How much time is it gonna take? How many more damn times do I have to go around the kitchen to get my 20,000 steps? So, a quick math problem is my kids are 30 years younger than me. They always will be. My wife is half my size and eats half the amount of calories, and plus I love bacon. So I'm never gonna be the most fit person in my family. In fact, I'm probably gonna be the most unfit person forever, but why would I keep doing it then? Why would I continue on? Well, I guess I can tell you that I do it for my wife, so that her and I will grow old together, and I do it for my children, so that they will know their father well into their adulthood, and that their children someday will know their grandfather. Madam Contest Chair.